Today, Nigeria claims, and I underline the word claims, that is the largest economy in Africa, with a GDP of about $550 billion, with possibly a population of about 200 million. They have never had a census in the recent past. If they have had one, nobody believes it. And there is every possibility that the population of Nigeria in 2050 will be about 1 billion of them. Nigeria relies on oil. 80% of its income is from oil production. It suffers from what commentators describe as the Dutch disease. Nigeria is incapable of producing enough rice for her people, but they love jollof rice. They are incapable of producing enough chili, and they love their chili. They are incapable of producing enough tomatoes, and they love their tomatoes. They are incapable of doing things, not because they do not have the ability, but a conscious decision has been made by people at critical positions to concentrate on oil as the milch cow for Nigeria. So going forward, what one must ask, particularly an organization such as AGRA and NEPAD and the African Union, what real interventions must be made in Nigeria? Because Nigeria is a true potential giant in that regard. If Nigeria were to wake up from her slumber, then the entire West African region would wake up from her slumber. Because when one has analyzed Nigeria and the plight of Nigeria and our inability as we speak now to produce enough food for ourselves, one need not analyze Mali. One need not analyze Senegal. One need not analyze the little Benin and the little Togo and the little Gabon and the little Cameroon, because the story is the same in that part of the world. Those of you who have gone to that part of the world, getting milk in the shelves of the stores in those countries is as difficult as getting snow in hell.